worked! Hi, it's Todd from Todd's Workshop and Todd Cutler here. And today I'm back with my trebuchet and a whopping big dart. Well, two of them actually. So what were these things about? Well, they might be complete fantasy, but if you look in the pictures, the manuscript pictures, they are there. Lots in Arabic texts, less in European texts, but both Francesco Martini, who was another one of these sort of sculptor, engineer, architect, polymath guys like Leonardo da Vinci and Mariano Taccola, they're all in the same kind of group of work that they did. Both Taccola and Martini show darts in trebuchet troughs. The Arabs did it a lot. So it's a thing. And if it's a thing, and I've got a trebuchet, I have to find out what's happening. So I've got a couple of them, and we're going to shoot them off. But the thing is, these are weighing in at about 3.5 kilos, about 4 pounds, something like that. I am pretty sure, and I'm really annoyingly can't find the picture from Taccola at the moment, but I'm pretty sure he showed two in the trough at the same time. So I'm going to shoot, well, the two of them, and then this is just about heavy enough, I'll be able to shoot one and keep the machine relatively safe. But we'll do that after in case it busts. But here we go. Let's shoot two of them, see what happens. I've got my darts now sitting in the trough, and I've just put it on one rope. Looks a bit precarious, so it might get exciting when I shoot. Let's see what happens. Here we go, two giant darts. No idea what's going to happen. Loose! Oh! Yes! Oh, that is fabulous. That is absolutely fabulous. Miss my men at arms, but they always do that. I even tried to attract it to them by putting a GoPro next to it. Anyway, didn't work. Let's go see what we got. Well, that was absolutely glorious. And I just so hope I managed to catch those two arrows, two darts, going up through the air together and falling together. Because it was, from where I was standing, it was just brilliant. So they've come down about 6 metres apart. Well, you know, that's trebuchets for you. One of them's broken. Doesn't really matter. It's a single-use item. Very tedious for me today, but I have gaffer tape. So we're going to go again. And we're going to see if we can hit our man-at-arms. Even with me teasing with the GoPro, Graham the Fourth or whoever he is, we're going to see if we can destroy him in various ways today. Fabulous. Right, let's go again. Oh, blimey. I thought that was going to be easy. Well, that was absolutely brilliant to see. I just loved it. But the thing is, the trebuchet has to be rigged a little differently now to when we do the sling and the bowling balls. So I'll explain what the difference is. So first of all, we've got this head here and it's got a little hook. And then we've got a loop on the end of the rope. And the loop is kept open by a wooden wedge. So it's a very free, very open connection that will drop away easily. So have a look at this. There you go. Now with the sling, you leave one end attached onto the arm, and that way the ball goes flying, you keep the sling, works beautifully. But in this case, if you left the rope attached to the spear, which you could do, it would create an awful lot of drag, so you'd lose distance. If you leave the rope attached to the trebuchet arm, it will just rotate this around and slam them straight down into the ground. So what happens now is the rope slips off the arm, just as it normally would, but then also this is now traveling through the air, and it goes traveling through the air, bit of wind resistance, and the rope just falls away. Cleanest possible release. No friction, no complication, utter repeatability. It's a really simple system. The only thing is, you just need to go find your rope again. Right, enough of the chitter chatter, we're gonna go again. Here we go again, pair of darts, loose! Oh! If I thought the first one looked good, the second one was just awesome. So these darts were just side by side the whole way through and came down within 1.5 metres of each other. It was epic. It was so very cool. We're going to go again. And loose! Oh! Oh! Nice! Now those are things are just undoubtedly so very, very cool. Reason enough, surely. But in a real sense, what is the point? Let's collect them and talk about it. Now, there is one thing I have decided about these, and this is a fact. No questions. These are very cool. They are very cool indeed. But is that reason enough to use them on a battlefield where pragmatism and effectiveness are generally more important? Now, the thing is, the Arab text, you can find quite a few pictures of these things, actually pictures of trebuchets with the darts in them. So they were obviously doing it.
Europeans, you can find in the works of Taccola and Martini, you can find them as sort of like textbook sketches, but not battlefield, or I haven't seen one, not battlefield manuscript pictures of darts and trebuchets. So I'm going to guess here, less done in Europe. Maybe it was just known about and speculatively mentioned. Maybe it's just known about and speculatively drawn, and actually it wasn't really done. But the Arabs did it. So we're going to come back to that. So the thing is, why would you do it? And this comes back to the old chestnut of wheels on trebuchets again. I've flip-flopped on my decisions about this, whether they did or whether they didn't. Now, there are some things which seems to be the case. They are definitely more efficient. You know, the work of Tom Stanton, for instance, and various documentaries have shown that. That's the case. You can argue that you don't want to build one within the bowshot of a wall, of a garrison, because it's going to be very dangerous. That's fact. But then you look at the medieval manuscript pictures, the actual pictures of trebuchets, and I cannot find a single one with wheels on them. I can't find them. So I'm going to say now, again, change my mind, yet again, they didn't have wheels on trebuchets. They might have put them on rollers, brought them in, but they didn't put wheels on them. So these things are static. Now what that means is that weight for weight, an arrow is going to be less drag than a rock. It is more aerodynamic. That means it's going to go further. So the only reason I can think of, except for reason one, cool as heck, is that they go that little bit further. And so when your trebuchet has exhausted its distance and you need just a little bit more to harass the enemy, darts. That's it. That's my reason. Except for reason one. Cool as heck. Fact. But the other thing is, some of you may have noticed throughout this film, there's been a GoPro mount on here. I think it's time we found out the bird's eye view. I've killed three GoPros in the past. Will this be number four? Loose! Oh-ho! Oh, nice and down. So you've just seen a bit of GoPro footage. I don't know if it's a world's first, who cares? But anyway, it was crazy. It went absolutely bonkers. And the reason was, I decided to put one dart in because I didn't want the other dart knocking against the GoPro and stuff. I thought it'd be cleaner. But actually, there was such a yank from the trebuchet on the start. Look at that. It just bent the fin completely on the front of my dart. And as a consequence, it just spun through the air and it went, yeah, you saw the footage. But the thing is, I've tried to do this before, actually, and I had a different approach last time with my dart. I had a housing at the front, really heavily armoured housing with the GoPro set back maybe about 20 centimetres, 8 inches. It hit the deck and it just extruded soil up into the casing. Thankfully, I hadn't put GoPro in that time, just wanted to test it. So these pictures here just show how difficult it was to protect it as an armoured job. So this time, I've just gone lightweight. Graham the fourth, maybe the fifth, who knows? I'll straighten that, we'll go again. And loose! Whoa! Yes! Lovely, 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 lovely! Let's try and find the GoPro in a cornfield. Yay! I just watched the GoPro footage and I just love the way that you could see the other dart in that. It's just brilliant. So cool. So trebuchet is cool, we know that. Giant darts and trebuchet, cool. So that's cool times cool. Can you make it even cooler? Well, plum barter, you've got to get them in everywhere. Now these are horrible scrappy ones, I'll show you in a minute. But basically, what you can do is you can put a support ring on your main dart. That holds the butt of your plum barter, put a cord around it with a burning fuse link. Time the fuse link right, this will carry it to target, these will deploy. So, well, multiple deployment system, fantastic. Cluster munitions, brilliant. Could they have done it? Well, I mean, did they do it? Almost certainly not. Could they have done it? Yes, they could. There's nothing to stop them. They had fused technology at the same time that trebuchets were around. It's absolutely possible. So they could do that. Now, the question is, would they have done it with real plum barter? Yeah, they probably would. Because if you're going to go to the effort of besieging somewhere, you'll make effort. These ones are not them. So if you have a look, it's just a wooden shaft, lump of clay, some hazard tape. Now the thing is, the farmer, the lovely, lovely farmer, who has mowed a strip so we can carry on playing in his cornfield with our trebuchet, drives tractors in there. I don't want to lose plum barter in that field. I don't want to lose them for me, and I don't want to lose them so that they spike his tyres. So these can stay out there till the end of the harvest, then I can collect the hazard tape. There's no problem. No problem. Also, they're cheap. Are they effective? Well, check this out. They self-correct beautifully, they throw beautifully, and they cost about 5 pence each. And they're free, actually, if you go and dig your own clay. So we're going to put those on to our shaft here, tie it up with a fusible link, GoPro, see them spread, launch them. I don't know, maybe they'll scatter and launch, maybe they'll, well, stay the course and we'll do it. But we're going to find out. Let's do that now. Attempt one, multiple deployment darts. Short fuse, I'm going to have to be fast. That was very, very epic indeed. It worked! It worked brilliantly! To conclude, these things are great. So the giant arrow is great, plus the munition version, absolutely great. Did they do it? I think probably not, because I think they're probably a bit too fiddly. You know, it'd be a bit hit or miss, if you excuse the joke. But could they have done it? Yes, they could. Are they cool as heck? They absolutely are. And for those of you who are curious, this bent again, as you saw it in the GoPro footage, it bent after it left the machine. So I think the arm of the trebuchet must have come down and yanked the cord before it properly left the machine. Because that happened in the air, not on launch, which is really weird. Anyway, it worked. It was fantastic. It was good fun. See you again. Thanks. Thank you.